Welcome back to another video, everybody. I am in downtown Fullerton, Los Angeles, actually at the train tracks down here at the train station in Fullerton. And last night I shot some event photography with my friend, YouTuber and photographer, Wes Creasel of Wes Creasel Photography and Photo. And we have five best tips for great event photography. So we thought it'd be a great idea to share our best practices, our best tips on shooting event photography. Tip number one. Okay, tip number one may or may not have anything to do with the actual event, but it's actually pre-planning for the event, and that's to get to the event early. That means preparing for the long drive, the short haul. Sometimes we procrastinate. Get there early because you never know if you're gonna have an accident per se, God forbid, but you may run into some type of situation where you have a flat tire. You just never know what's gonna happen. So get early to an event. Prepare yourself.
Tip two is to know the space. And to know the space, you have to walk the floor. And when you walk the floor, here's four things that you should pay attention to. One is I try on all my lenses from different aspects of the room and take some test shots just to see the framing and the composition. So that's one idea, is take some practice shots as you walk the room. But don't just look at the composition, look at the lighting sources. You're gonna notice that photos in one area of the room might come out bright because there's additional windows or lighting, and some areas are dark. So you should know those ahead of time because you're walking the room to see what the lighting sources are. Also, look for reflective surfaces. Sometimes you're taking photos with a flash and there might be a gleam in a window behind people. You'll wanna know that so you can stage yourself kind of at an angle and avoid that. And you wanna also look for the traffic, the flow. Where are the aisles? Where are the walkways? Where is it possibly you're gonna get jammed up and not be able to get to a certain place because of traffic, and you gotta figure out other ways around the venue, like, you know, churches or reception halls where there's one long aisle. Those are notorious. So that's a tip for getting to know your venue.
This is tip number three. Go west.
You wanna seek out both candid shots and pose shots. I was in LA at an event recently, and the band was setting up ahead of time, and I realized I wouldn't be able to get into the band space because they're right at the front of the room, and to be able to take photos of them, I would have to be kind of in the presentation area. So I had the band pose and play through. They were warming up anyways, but I just let them know, hey, I want you to pose and I'm gonna take some shots and some video of you. Candid shots, look for people enjoying themselves. What the person who hired you wants is evidence that people had a great time. So look for people laughing. You wanna get those candid moments that don't always come off on camera when you pose them. So look for people laughing. And you know, with a telephoto lens and a flash, you can actually pull off some pretty stealth work and get some people really enjoying themselves, and they're not really aware that the photographer is capturing that moment until they see it later. And then the client who hires you says, great job, I didn't know you captured that moment. Yes, I did.
Yes, sir. Tip number four. Number four. Interact with your guests. It's so important to let guests know that you're having a great time at the event as well. You don't wanna be a lump on a log, a person that goes to the actual event and starts just shooting photos without having any kind of connection. Connection is energy, energy is connection. Make sure that you are looking people in the eye, shaking their hands, asking them questions, and engaging them, actually gathering them up for candids and poses. So just make sure that, well, I guess you wouldn't be doing that for candids, right? You're gonna be a little bit stealthy more for candids, but, Wes just talked about that. But when you're gonna go and pose somebody, it's super important to make those connections, eyeball people, and just have a good time along with them, and they'll just feel like you're part of the party. And then who doesn't like a good party goer, right? So make sure that you're having a lot of fun while you're doing it, because you should be. It's photography, and we love photography. Tip number five, have situational awareness. What does situational awareness mean? It means that you should be looking out, head on a swivel, making sure that you see what's going on in the event. Remember, we're trying to tell a story as photographers for event photography, and we're trying to capture most of the event. You're not gonna capture everything, but if you're keeping an awareness of everything that's going on around you, more often than not, you're gonna be able to capture those moments that are super special. For example, I caught a shot where the person won a prize and I turned around quickly and I saw her getting up and she celebrated with her hands up. That was super special. Be a helpful photographer. That is also situational awareness. If there's somebody that might need help that has nothing to do with photography, help them out. There was a guest that had won a prize, but her hands were full. She had a blanket and a jacket and a wine glass in her hand. And I said, hey, can I get that wine glass out of your hand and put it off to the side while you go and get your prize? And just be a good, helpful photographer. That goes a long way. Those are the five best tips to make great event photography. And wait a minute. Wait a minute. There is more. Go over to Wes's channel. He has more photography tips on shooting amazing, great event photography that'll make your event that much more special. Please subscribe. Please click that bell to remind you of when I upload a video. Please like this video if you liked any part of it. Love you guys. Peace. Yeah, good info. Like what we just did.
Yeah. More, but good. Good and more.
That's not good grammar.
Click the button. Subscribe once.
Please. That's it. That's a video, son.
That's good. That's good.